taking it to the streets about online dating, the hype dance troupe, and the naturals. All this and more because this is Marquette Live.
Welcome to Marquette Style. I'm Catherine.
And I'm Kevan.
And tonight we have a very special guest, Elizabeth Johnson. She's a style icon on campus, a senior in the College of Communication, and she is the campus rep for so many fashion brands on campus. So, Elizabeth, what are you representing and what are you doing for these brands?
So, I was hired for a lot of brands just to kind of get the word out about them. So a lot of them are newer brands and they're kind of starting off. So I was hired basically to do their social media and then to also wear their clothes around campus, which is a great perk. So what I do is I'm a brand representative for Nat Belt Company as well as Vineyard Vines. Both are based out on the East Coast. One's out of Martha's Vineyard and the other's out of Boston. So what I do for them is I essentially do a lot of kind of events on campus to raise awareness, and then for other companies I do like U-Scoop and Tuckernuck, which are more of blogging companies for fashion. So it's been really fun and it works really well into my advertising major.
Oh, yeah. Sounds interesting.
That's awesome. I want free clothes sent to me.
Right. Okay, so we all have our favorite fashion inspiration. Mine personally is Rihanna. So what is your favorite like fashion inspiration?
I've got to go to Jacqueline Kennedy. I think she just has the most classic look, and it's so simple, and she never had to wear a lot of makeup. She never kind of really had to go out there with being, you know, looking great, and she always did look great. And so I think that was one of the things that I really appreciated, and it's kind of timeless look that I like to kind of bring into my closet.
Yeah. Well, it's always best to keep it simple. You know, I don't want to overdo it, so.
Well, it's just awesome because in 30 years, you'll look at the pictures and be like, I looked great. Whereas with sometimes with trends, when you take in a lot of trends, then you're going to look back and be like, oh, my Lord.
Right.
My
right.
Mom's going through that right now.
So fashion brands, how do you stay so fashionable and do it on a budget?
I shop a lot of sales. So hitting up, you know, going to J. Crew, working the sales there, or going to outlets even for little simple pieces. I do like to splurge for those pieces that I know I'm going to wear a lot. So kind of worth the investment there, but making sure that I'm also keeping that budget is very important. So making sure that you do find those great deals out there. TJ Maxx is a good one too.
Right.
I love TJ Maxx. I used to work there.
Maxinista. Yep. You also worked at Charlotte Russe.
Yeah.
You. So. She's the fashionable girl here, clearly. Love the outfit.
Love the shoes.
So you talked about like splurging for, you know, the things that you'll be able to wear more. So what is like your like top basic pieces that you'll need like in the closet?
I think great shirts that can go under blazers or things that you know you're gonna wear a lot, great pants, really mm-hmm. nice shoes. So I'm in the market for a pair of black boots right now, looking for that, making sure that I know that they're gonna last and I'm gonna be able to wear them a lot. So just knowing that you're gonna repeat those items and then pairing them with cheaper items that you know you can kind of toss after a couple of years.
Great.
Okay, so I have a question for you, and I am one of these people that I never wear sweatpants to school ever. And people always ask me, like, how do you not wear sweatpants? And I'm just like, I don't know. I just can't.
It's fashionable.
I can't. But how do you have the energy every morning to be like, no to the comfortable sweatpants and yes to pairing a great outfit together every day?
I just feel like a slob if I wear sweatpants. I did it in
exactly.
high school. You can't do it.
Yeah.
And so I think if I'm going to get around then, I do want to be comfortable. I'll put on a pair of leggings with a long oversized Oxford and a pair of boots and call it a day. It's essentially the same thing as being in a pair of sweatpants, but it looks a lot more put together.
Yeah. Even if I do wear sweatpants, I'll make it a little bit more fashionable. You know, I have to add something to it to, you know, stand out.
Yeah.
That's what I like to do. So.
My new favorite idea for sweatpants is like a tighter sweatpant. I recently splurged on one at J. Crew, and it's tighter, and then I'm going to pair it with like Western cowboy booties and like an oversized sweater and scarf. Cool. And like that's a way to make it fashionable, incorporate low items and chic items and call it a day, which yeah. I personally like.
Big fan.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming to the show.
Problem.
We enjoyed you.
It was a pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Thank you. And until next week.
Great interview, girls. And as always, thank you for the fabulous fashion tips. We got to take our first break, but don't go anywhere because we'll be right back with more of Marquette Live. Welcome back to Marquette Live. I'm your host, Jessica Clark. Continuing on with our show, we have the always suave Sebastian, who took it to the streets to ask people what they think about online dating. It's thought it'd be interesting. Let's see what people had to say. Sebastian?
Hi, everyone. Today, in Dating 101, we took to the streets to see what Marquette thought about online dating. Dating 101, here we go. Guys, what do you guys feel about online dating?
Online dating kind of weirds me out, actually.
Yeah, just a tad. You don't really know who you're talking to. You could be an old fat guy, so you don't know.
You really have to do your research. Some pictures might be not completely true. Have you ever looked someone up on Facebook?
Yeah, I have done before in the past. I think everyone has.
But you guys aren't, you would be able to do some Facebook, let's call it flirting on the chat, right?
Definitely. Mm-hmm. Definitely. All for that.
Facebook really is the spectrum for teenagers to flirt a little bit online, just like these two ladies did. What do you think about actually dating someone online?
I feel like it's stupid. I mean, like, you don't get to, like, actually
talk. Be physically intimate or talking? Would you ever use it yourself?
I mean, at this point in my life, I haven't exactly warmed up to it yet. I wouldn't necessarily be, like, opposed to it, maybe, if, like, down the road I have, like, 27 cats and, like, there's no person there with me.
It was a bad experience. Could you tell us a little bit more about that experience?
Yeah, I met one guy online, and then we were chatting for, like, 2 months, and after when I saw him, he didn't even could look at me on the face, and it was, like, a very weird date. So bad.
Do you know if your parents met online?
They did not, but my cousin and his wife did.
And they have a successful marriage?
Yes, they do. They have 4 children.
You can meet online, you can have children and people. It is true. Not only creeps out there. After a hard day of interviewing, we have found out many things about the Marquette students. Most of them like the idea of online dating, but they think they are too young to actually start doing it. However, everybody is flirting on Facebook, and that's what you should be doing too. That's it for today. Keep on dating, Marquette.
I always was a bit uneasy with the whole online dating. I think it's kind of like that Forrest Gump quote where you never really know what you're going to get. Am I right? But thanks, Sebastian. That was great. Next, we got another awesome interview from the lovely Lo Holman and Marquette Hype's dance troupe. Over to you, Lo.
Thanks, Jessica. Hey, guys. Welcome back to another week of What's Up, Marquette. I'm Lauren Holman with your weekend update for November 16th. Friday night will be a little bit of a quiet one on campus, but the MU Cash Cow will be out for prizes up the wazoo. Cash Cow will be running at 7 until 11 p.m. all weekend long, and you can always use it to head over to this weekend's movie at the Varsity. The Marquette's late night movie special will feature a flick called Total Recall, starring Colin Farrell, Kate Beckinsale, and Jessica Biel. Total Recall will be showing at the Varsity Theater on Friday at 9 p.m. and Saturday at 7 and 10 p.m. Saturday, the catwalk comes alive with a 16-years-old fashion show. It'll take the catwalk at 7 p.m. on the AMU ballrooms. Seating will begin at 6:30 p.m., and tickets will be $12 at the door. All proceeds will be donated to the Youth Development for Change, a local Milwaukee nonprofit organization. Hype Marquette will be taking the stage this Saturday at the Weasel Auditorium. The fall showcase will begin at 3 p.m., and admission is free. However, the dance crew will be taking donations to benefit the National Multiple Scoliosis Society. If in attendance, please be generous to the cause. This week, I actually had the opportunity to crash on Hype Marquette's practices and interview some of Marquette's finest hip hoppers.
Hey guys, it's Lil Holman here with Hype Marquette's newest faces, their Hype babies, Sanjana and Jake. In case you guys know what Hype Marquette was, it's Marquette's only and premier hip-hop group here on campus. How are you guys doing today?
Doing great.
Great.
Awesome. Now, I know you guys just got done with practice, so you're a little worn out. How are you guys feeling, though, about the show coming up?
Super excited. I think the group overall has been putting a lot of work into it, and this is my first real access to a group like this, like a hip-hop group, so I think it's really challenging overall, with leading to a great outcome.
Sanjana, how do you feel about that yourself?
I agree fully. I think that we've worked really, really hard. We have practices twice a week for 2 hours each, and we just put a lot of effort into it, so hopefully it shows on stage.
Great. Now, I know this is your first year. Are there any challenges you guys have faced balancing this and school?
Well, I actually like the challenge between balancing this and school because I usually come straight from the library, so it's the perfect recreation that I need in the day, perfect break I need, and then right afterward, I go back to study, and so it's the perfect break I need in the day, and it's something that I love to do.
I think so too. You know, when I came to college, I wanted to do something with dance, and I just think, you know, as much as I really do need to balance school, and at first it was a little bit of a struggle, but I think the more that you learn to balance it, the better time you're gonna have in college. So
totally agree with that. Now tell me, have you guys have any previous hip-hop experience before you guys decided to join Hype, or you just decided to do it on a whim?
Back in high school and a little bit of middle school, I did kind of my own thing, not really part of a group. And I worked for different like entertainment companies, but this is my first real hip hop group.
And I danced hip hop since eighth grade. I was part of a company for a couple years, and then I joined the school team as well. And then I decided to come here, so yeah.
That's great. So as far as like your growth and development, because like I said, this is your first year, do you feel like Hype has really like been a positive outlet for you guys to really like grow as like dancers and hip hoppers too?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's the perfect access to making friends with upperclassmen, which I think is crucial. I go to a lot of the Hype members for advice about just things in general with Marquette, and it just makes me feel a lot cooler knowing these upperclassmen and hanging out with them here and there.
I think so too, actually. The people here are so sweet. They're just, you know, we call ourselves the Hype family because they're really, really close. We're all close to each other, and you know, we like as much as we put a lot of work in here, we're here to have a lot of fun, so it's great.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, just how hyped up are you guys for the show?
11.
20.
Oh, that's great. Well, thank you guys so much, and I hope and look forward to see you guys when you perform in your showcase.
Thank you.
Well, I'm back here with Emily Ruthenberg talking about Hype Marquette and all the awesome things we have to look forward to this season. So Emily, tell me, what other things can we expect from Hype in their appearances?
Okay, so this past weekend we performed at the Dance Inc. show, and previously this semester we also performed at a breast cancer awareness event. In the upcoming weeks, we hope to be performing at things such as the Best Buddy show that we did last year. So we like to perform at philanthropy events to get our name out there.
Now, are you guys taking donations again at your show for a certain community service event or community service group here in Milwaukee?
Yes, we are. Not necessarily for Milwaukee, but for the Multiple Sclerosis Foundation. We try and do different ones every semester, and that's just the one that we came up with as a team.
Great. So how did you guys choose that one?
Actually, my dad has multiple sclerosis. He was diagnosed 30 years ago. So I like to give back to that foundation.
That's fantastic. The fact that you can do something that you love and also miss it with something that you really have near and dear to your heart. So tell me, what else? Since I know this is your third year in Hype, how has your Hype journey been so far throughout your years of college at Marquette?
Oh my gosh, it's been the saving grace to my education career, definitely. I have had a hard semester, this semester especially, so just coming to practice really lightens my mood, and I always enjoy it. So,
great. Well, thank you, Emily. I really appreciate you taking out the busy time for your schedule, getting ready for the show and whatnot. You guys can all look forward to having Hype Marquette in their showcase. It's going to be this Saturday at the Weisler Auditorium starting at 5 p.m., so make sure you're there and you're ready to hype it up.
Talking to those guys made me miss dancing all over again. Tryouts for next year? Who knows? Well, that just about does it for me, Marquette. Thanks for joining me this week on Marquette's Weekend Update. I'm Lauren Holman. Back to you, Jessica.
Ever since I saw Save the Last Dance and the first Step Up movie, because let's be honest, all the other ones after that were just awful, I always wanted to be a dancer, or maybe I just wanted to dance with Channing Tatum. I mean, what girl doesn't, let's be real. Regardless, thanks to Lo and to Hype for an awesome interview. We got to take another break, but keep it locked, because when we return, we'll have some more music greatness with Erica. Don't go away. Welcome back to Marquette Live. To wrap up our show tonight, we have Erica Forrest, who got the chance to hang out with the Naturals. Over to you, Erica.
Welcome back, Marquette. This week, I have a very noteworthy treat for you. I had the opportunity to get the VIP treatment in the Naturals practice. And it is safe to say that I most certainly walked out of there both starstruck and in love. The gentlemen even got dressed up for me in their bow tie swag. This exclusive performance is one you definitely do not want to miss. Check it out.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned. turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, and tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing and relaxing, all cool and all, shooting that b-ball outside of the school, when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in the neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared, and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle to Bel Air." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, y'all home's to Bel Air. I rolled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Y'all home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there, sitting on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Here's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold like their mother. The youngest one in curls. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch.
In movies and sex on TV, but where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely? Lucky there's a Family Guy. Lucky there's a man who positively can do all the things that make us laugh and cry.
Performance, the boys were nice enough to give me a fabulous interview. There was laughter, there was talk of ladies, and there was some fierce competition. Let's take a look.
Well, first of all, I just want to say that that was an amazing performance. I had goosebumps the entire time. And second of all, it's just like you guys have so much fun up there when you're doing your thing. So, how long does it take you guys to really master a song once you get it? Or how do you decide who gets what parts, and what's that process?
We usually have a set group of people who work the different parts, so 4 guys on each part, and each song typically takes us about a week to learn how it goes, and then to master it's a whole different process. You have to add in the dynamics, and you have to add in the musical feel, not just the notes. Make it an enjoyable song to both listen to and sing. Something for the audience to enjoy and make it an entertaining piece. So I would say probably about 50% of the semester is learning the music, and then 50% of the other half of that semester is mastering the music.
Which you have definitely done, I will say. So then, how did you guys come together? Like, is there an audition process, or did you have a bunch of cuts? You guys are the ones that made it?
Yes. I guess I'm a junior, so we have two or three current seniors and two super seniors. So they were, several of them were in the group before I joined, but it's...
Some joined the group when others were in eighth grade.
We're in eighth grade. But basically, our audition process is we hold auditions at the beginning of the fall semester and the beginning of the spring semester. We basically go out to O-Fest and orientation week and put our name out there and try to get people to audition. And then for the auditioning process, we have people come in and sing a solo and go over some sight reading and tonal memory so we can kind of gauge their aptitude as singers. And then from there, we take people based on how many spots we kind of want to fill and based on how good the singers are for that batch.
Who's we, so. The seniors or the people that have?
It's really a group effort.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, like, the seniors aren't going to be there the year after, so
yes.
You want to make sure that the younger generation
also
have say in who's in the group too.
But. Something we've done different this year, I thought worked out really well, is for auditions, we put out a song. We gave the guys coming in a song. We had them learn. It's a simple arrangement, four-part harmony. And we had them sing it together so that we could hear the way they blended. Because obviously that matters so much when you sing a song. So like Corey said, all the things there, it's hard enough, but we've made it a little bit more difficult, and I think we've turned out some really great, great voices here because of it.
Definitely. So you guys definitely have some celebrity status on campus, I would say. Do you have any wild fan stories in your shows or anything? Anything crazy that people have shouted out?
We're
or?
Pretty active audience on Twitter.
Yeah, for the list.
Yeah.
They get pretty into our, like during the concert especially, we had a huge influx of people tweeting about us and how excited they were to be at the concert and their favorite songs. So our bow tie swag hashtag has kind of been like our championing call. And so we get a lot of people sending cool pictures. We sang at a late night event for MUSG earlier this year and told everyone to tweet pictures of their own bow ties. Craft night, and so we got a bunch of pictures of girls like making bow ties and signs, and it's just they get really into like interacting with us on Twitter, which is really
well,
great.
So exciting, I have such a huge following. So who would you say is the biggest ladies man then?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, that's me.
That's all.
Look at that
all
smile. Killer smile. Smile for the camera.
He does. Killer smile.
Hair looks great.
It's the hair. It's all the hair and the glasses.
I agree.
And just
with the bow tie,
it's
just...
Tie.
Yes. And then beatboxing. Who would you say wins in that category? Most do we need to have a beatbox off right now? Does that need to happen?
Yeah.
Christmas concert or upcoming events, check out munaturals.com for everything you need to know.
God, you're worse than 70s news.
You stay classy, James. Stay classy.
munaturals.com!
Buy now! Buy now!
Well, Marquette, I know I will absolutely be front row at their Christmas concert next month, and I better see you there. I want to give a huge thank you shout out to all of the talented boys of the Naturals. Until next time, I'm Erica Force, and this is Everything Marquette Music. I'll see you guys next week.
Galisha me. Those guys sounded amazing. I've never heard a more beautiful version of the Brady Bunch. People got tearing up in here and everything. Thanks for that, Erica. It was fantastic. Well, that just about sums up our show. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next week, same time, same place. I'm Jessica Clark, and this has been Marquette Live. Have a great weekend.